Let's get started on our animated background. So to get that up and running, we need to go to the dashboard component. And then in here, in the opening div tag, we're going to add an ID. We're going to call it BG for background. And then we're going to add a class. And that class is going to say animate you. Okay, we don't need this anymore. Temporarily, we're going to add some style tags. We don't really need scoped on here. The first thing we're going to do is at keyframes. And then we're going to say hue. And then we're going to say it's 0%. We'll have a filter. And it's going to be hue rotate at 0 degrees. And then also we're going to add WebKit filter. You rotate, and that's also going to be 0 degrees. This is mainly for Firefox. That's what these styles, when you have WebKit, it's usually for Firefox. 100%. We're going to have a filter of you rotate minus 360 degrees, and then another WebKit filter with the hue rotate of minus 360 degrees. Fantastic. Now under the keyframes, we'll have the hashtag BG, and we'll give it background, linear gradient, hashtag FF0088, and that'll give it a nice red and a nice purple. Now we're going to go ahead and position this. Absolute. We're going to give it a left of 0. And I'm sure you could do this in Tailwind. I'm going to add the link to where I got all of this from. I'm going to give you the link in a bit. But for now, just code with me. A right of 0. Origin 0. Auto. And the height of 100 view height. Okay, then after that, we are going to add on that BG, animate hue, we're going to add that class to it. And then it's going to be animation name hue, which is what we defined up here. Animation duration, 500 seconds. Animation delay, 1 second. Animation iteration count infinite, so it's going to go on and on and on. And now we'll add our WebKit. We could probably do something. Copy, paste, add a line for that here, 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 here. Say WebKit animation, so all of that's the same. Now let's go ahead and check it out in our browser. Refresh. Okay, and we didn't, so let's check our inspect tools and see if we got any errors. Okay, no errors, so let's see what's going on. Gradient. Okay, let's try it again, head back to the browser, refresh. Okay, cool, now we have it. Close this. And as you can see, the color's changing. It's really a beautiful layout. So before I go any further, I want to say that this background was not my idea. I did find it on YouTube, and I ended up finding the person's, the developer's website, where he has, this is what he used. And if you go to his GitHub, it'll give you the link to his code, and you can see some of his other projects. He does really, really nice work. So I will leave a link for this website down in the description. Go give him a checkout and, you know, maybe like the video or something for him as well. I think that would be really nice. Okay, so yeah, look at this. Oh, it changes. I love this background. Okay, so now let's go ahead and put an image file in the background for this. Now, since we already have a current song property in our data section down here, we can use this to add an image for us. So up here, we'll just say image. And then we'll do some backticks. And then we'll say storage. And then we'll add, outside of the backticks, we'll say current song cover. And we also need the colon for here. Okay, we're going to give it a class of opacity 25, width full, height full. And also for the alt, we can just do current song title. Now let's head back to the browser and make sure we're getting that image. It's still going. And we don't have an image, but I think that's because, yeah, we haven't actually put covers in here yet. So I'm going to go ahead and overwrite this songs file or this songs property. So over a little bit. Okay, and now we actually have image. So why don't I change that to this, and this. I'll just change this to cover. Okay, so now let's head back, refresh, and okay, I think I know why. So we have storage here, but we don't yet have that in our actual link because we haven't pulled them yet from the database. So we can actually get rid of this storage here. And now we should be good. So refresh. Okay, and now we have our image finally. What I want to do is this style, I don't really like it being in the component. Mainly the reason is if you wanted to split it up into different pages instead of just the one, I would want to use this background on everything. This is my personal preference. It does not have to be yours. If you want to just keep it here, you can just scope it in the component. But for this demonstration, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up resources, CSS, and app.css. And I'm just going to add that right under the Tailwind stuff. Okay, so this way that it'll be global and we'll just have it everywhere. If you want to switch it out, you can. Obviously, it's your project. But this is the way I'm going to do it. Fantastic. So if that worked correctly, we should have the same information. This shouldn't have changed. Okay, so we'll go ahead and refresh. All good, it's still the same. So I'm going to leave it there for now. I'm going to make sure to push this code up to GitHub and leave the link down in the description. I will also leave Dominic's link, his website, in the description as well for you guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.